Hello everyone, I'm Ihsan. In today's video, we'll see the must-use application on your Samsung smartphone. This application is quite useful application on your Samsung smartphone if you use the full screen gesture feature. For those of you who are already using the full screen gesture feature, you must use this application to help you navigate your smartphone. By using the One Hand Operation Plus application, you can use the smartphone faster with shortcut and gestures that you can customize by yourself. So for those of you who have never used this application and want to use it on your smartphone, or for those of you who want to see the list feature on this application, let's just find out all the features on this app. For those of you who have never used this application before, you can first install the application on Google Play Store, or if you don't find it on Google Play Store, you can also install the application on Galaxy Store. In the app, all you have to do is search for One Hand Operation Plus. Later, you just have to select this application icon from the Samsung Electronics Developer. After installing the application, you can only open the application. In this application, there are many settings that you can use to make navigating of your smartphone faster and easier. Basically, it is the same as in the previous version. For the left hand handle and the right hand handle, the settings are still quite the same. However, there are some additional features in the menu options section. For the setting of the left handle and right handle, the functions are the same as in the previous version, where the left handle is for the left hand axis and the right handle is for right side menu axis. Here for both, we'll apply the same settings, so we just set the right handle. In this video, we'll see the menus on the right handle, and later you just have to match it with the left handle setting. Okay, now let's go try into the setting of the right handle. In the right handle menu, there are three options: straight left, which swipes straight like this, and there's a diagonal up to swipe to the top. And the last one is diagonal down, to swipe to the bottom like this. So by activating this application, you can differentiate the swipe function for its direction. So swiping with a straight up and down can have different functions. Here we'll just leave it all to default, and if you want to differentiate them, you can also select them directly from this section. Here what I usually set is all the options for the back key. So even though you swipe down, swipe up, and swipe to the side, they all have the same function. However, if you want to change its function, you can immediately select, for example, diagonal down to swipe down like this. You can also select other functions. For example, you want the volume down key or volume down button, you can only swipe like this, and you can only display the volume button settings like this. However, usually here we set it for the back key only, so it doesn't get too confusing. Usually for other functions, we change in the long swipe section below, because for the long swipe, the movement is a little different from the short swipe. For the short one, sometimes when we swipe like this, we swipe a little bit down and it triggers this diagonal down feature. So to avoid getting it wrong when you back, you can set everything to back key in this short swipe section. And for additional features that you want to access for quick navigation, you can set it in this long swipe. Then here, for an example of using the long swipe, you can use the straight left for the quick tools feature. Virtual touchpad or start application can also be used. Here you can choose an application, for example, a calculator if you often use the calculator app. So when you long swipe straight like this, it will immediately open the calculator app. And you can immediately return to the previous application. So you can use this for a shortcut to open the application that you use most. Then for the long swipe, the straight left, you can also use it for the task switcher. This task switcher is for switching between apps, like in the app drawer. In the task switcher settings, there are also the newest features on this latest update, just like when you open the recent apps like this. However, the task switcher's interface is simpler and smaller, and you can access it directly with one hand. For these task switcher functions, you can immediately close the application in the recent apps. For example, if you want to close the application, all you have to do is press the X on the right, and for the option, now you can select it on the left. Here there are options: lock this app, open in split screen view, open in pop-up view, and app info. The settings are the same as those in the section of the task changer. Then besides the task switcher, you can also set it for the virtual touchpad. So to bring up the virtual touchpad, you just have to swipe and hold like this, and the virtual touchpad will immediately appear. So you can directly access the virtual touchpad by swiping at the bottom, and to close it, just press the X button. So when you want to use this virtual touchpad, you just have to swipe and the virtual touchpad will appear on the screen. In addition, you can also change its function to the quick tools option. By selecting quick tools, you can only long swipe on the right and the quick tools will appear in this section. In the quick tools section, you can only set the brightness and you can adjust the volume of the song. Then here you can also activate Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, lock the screen, take screenshot, and also flashlight. So you can use the quick tools functions immediately for various functions at once. For those of you who don't know what functions to use for this long swipe, you can just choose the quick tools because there are many settings that you can directly access with this quick tools option. Then for the diagonal up, for long swipe you can choose the volume up key, and for the diagonal down, for volume down key. So you can change the volume on your smartphone without pressing the physical button. You can immediately turn the volume down like this, or you can directly increase the volume by swiping upwards. This is certainly quite easy because if you swipe and hold, you can really get a button on the screen. So you no longer need to press the physical volume button. Then the new settings on One Hand Operation Plus on the latest update are located in the Advanced Settings menu. Here there is a feature that is quite interesting which was previously missing after updating to One UI 2.5. After updating to One UI 2.5, when we type on the keyboard and wanted to use gestures to return to previous app, we couldn't swipe on the keyboard anymore. However, after the latest update of One Hand Operation Plus in 2021, in the advanced settings section, there is an option for keyboard features that you can uncheck. So if you don't select this feature, you can go back on each side of the keyboard on full screen gestures. So for those of you who previously had issue with this back gesture, now you can take advantage of One Hand Operation Plus in the advanced features. In the advanced features section, all you have to do is uncheck the fit to keyboard option and you can immediately back right from the keyboard. Then the next settings that we usually use in One Hand Operation Plus is in the advanced settings section, which is animation. Here we usually choose the curved line, which is the third choice. So when you go back, there will be an interesting black effect like this. If you choose the default one, the arrow, the animation will look like this. And for the curve line, it looks more interesting because there is some jiggle effect. And for those of you who want a third look, you can only choose the curve line option. Then in the advanced settings section, there is also an option for app exception. So if there is an application that you don't want to activate the gesture of this One Hand Operation Plus application, you can activate it in the app exception option. For example, in the calculator application, you don't want to activate the gesture that we made earlier. So then when you open the calculator app, the gesture will not be activated on this app. Here you just need to adjust the application for the application that you don't want to activate the gesture. Next, there are the latest feature in the latest update of One Hand Operation Plus app in the gesture settings section. There is a quick action option for the short swipe and long swipe by activating this quick action feature. The swipe function will be activated immediately before you even take your hands off the screen. So the back function will be even faster than before. For example, if you activate this quick action later, the long swipe feature will not be active. So if you use the long swipe feature as we said earlier, you can turn off the quick action for the short swipe. And you can use this special quick action for long swipe only. So the long swipe feature can appear faster than before by activating this quick action. For the swipe distance, now there are also options for short and long one. So if you want to make the swipe accessible at a distance that is not too far away, you can slide it to the short part. So when you long swipe, the menu will appear pretty quickly. Then in the latest update of One Hand Operation Plus 2021, there are also new features in this gesture setting. There is a new gesture angles. Here you can set the angle when you swipe to the bottom or swipe to the top part of the screen. So here for angles, when you swipe down or swipe up, you can adjust it. Here you just need to adjust the angle according to your needs. If you want to return the settings to the default settings, you can only press the restore default settings button. And then the settings will return to their original version. Then let's go back to the preview setting. Let's have a look at the touch width settings at the bottom. You can shrink and enlarge it like this. And for the width, you can also adjust it right here. You can also set the position further up and down. So outside of this line later when you swipe, it won't work. So if there is a part of the screen that you don't want to use, when you swipe on the left or right side of the screen, you just need to adjust its position from this section. Then for the color of this handle, you can also make it completely transparent. Here you just have to choose white or any color and choose the opacity to 0%. So the handle will not appear on the screen at all. And in the latest update, there is also a spectrum option for more detailed colors than before. If you want to choose a color and want to display the color of this handle, you can set it to 100% and click done. Then on the side of the screen, a color will appear like this. And to completely get rid of the handle color, what you have to do is set the opacity to 0% and click done. And the handle will not appear at all on your screen. Then at the very bottom, there is also a custom vibration intensity option for vibration intensity when you swipe on the left or right side of the screen. So if you want a little vibration feedback, you can increase the vibration level a little bit. Or if you don't want any feedback, just set it to the lowest one to the left. So there will be no vibration feedback when you swipe on the screen when you access this one-hand operation plus application. If you like this kind of video, don't forget to like and also subscribe so you'll be notified when there is a new video from this channel. If you want further discussion about this topic, you can write in the comment section and it can also be in Telegram group. Or you can directly DM us to Instagram account @suntertainment. See you on the next one.